Okay, so here's a review of X-Men Gold and X-Men Blue. Believe me, it's not the only one blue. This straight up fucking sucks. It just straight up fucking sucks. There is no... Actually, let me rephrase. There's no redeeming quality to either of these. But no, the only real redeeming quality is the Muslim propaganda that's in this title. That's about the only redeeming quality of these. And you notice... Where is it? Oh, number one. You know why they do this? Because these folks here, fucking suck. They fucking suck. They suck dick at life. They are horrible. Not just these guys, but all the creators, apparently at Marvel, do not know how to do engaging fucking stories. You know the only reason that I'm going to get X-Men Blue number 2 and X-Men Gold number 2? You want to know why? Because I have a subscription, and I've had a subscription for over 25 fucking years. That's the only reason for me to come back to these titles. The only reason for me to come back to either of these titles is because I have been collecting Uncanny X-Men since like 300, okay? That's it. There is no reason to come back. These are throwaway stories. They're garbage. The art is kind of mediocre. Although, like, it started out with... And, like, you're okay. Okay. But then they get to Jean Grey, and she has just this weird fucking face. I don't know what they did. And speaking of weird faces, let me find it. Now, okay, so you got Juggernaut and Black Tom, which is cool. Okay, they're on a yacht, and you know Juggernaut's gonna break it. Okay, you know, it is what it is. Okay, it's Juggernaut. I'm the Juggernaut, bitch. Anyways, where's that? Look at this, I mean, just her face. Like, you look at these, okay. No, he looks like a frozen turd, but that's okay. Like, the way they draw her face is just... But there's this one, it's the derp face. It's like, where is it? Right here, this one. Look at that. He looks fine. I guess this is the closest thing to a splash page, which that's actually kind of cool. I actually kind of like that. It's kind of nice. It's a nice little panel. I like that. And then... Of course, you got Magneto. I don't know where his arms are, but that's okay. Yeah, where are his arms? I don't know. Whatever. And then they do this side story, and you're like, okay, dude's running through here. So, a bunch of animals died. What happened? Blah, blah, blah. I don't know. And also you hear, Wendigo. And all of a sudden, Blonde Wolverine shows up. I have no idea what the fuck this is. What? Look at that face. Why is he blonde? No. Why is he... What? Straight up garbage. Just fucking straight up garbage. If you had writers who could engage the audience, you wouldn't have to constantly do number fucking one. Because what happens... is, you know, noob, loser, kids, or whoever, sees this shit sitting on a rack somewhere, and they're like, it's number one, guys, we're going to pick it up. And then number two starts to trail off, number three trails off, number four trails off, then nobody buys the rest of them. So, about every 2 years, you're talking about 22, 23 issues, 24 issues, about every 2 years, they got to reboot it to number two. They're number one. Do you know how hard that is? As a longtime collector, to keep track of that shit. Because the way it was before, if I was missing a title, an issue, and let's say I went to the comic shop and I bought Uncanny X-Men, I don't know, 335. Well, guess what? It goes between 334 and 336. Now, this is X-Men Gold number one. I have no idea. Well, I mean, I happen to know, but 10 years from now, I'm not going to know that number one is the same as the number one from the last time they rebooted the series, or the time before that that they rebooted the series, or the time before that that they rebooted the series. So now I'm going to get X-Men number two. Now, obviously, it's going to have the blue and gold, so that's hopefully, you know, can keep track of that. So you got blue one, blue two. Okay, that is a little bit better. I mean, assuming they keep those titles, those blue and gold. Assuming they keep that. But you look at the last, like, five times they rebooted, there's no way to keep track of that shit. And keep in mind, I know what I'm doing here. You get a bunch of scrubs come in, and they're like, and they don't know what's going on. So this, straight up garbage. This one, now, I gotta be honest with you, the artwork is okay. I'm not a big fan of the faces. The cover is okay. I like the cover. The cover's not bad. This, Saif, dude. Now, this guy... okay, so you got fact news. There's all this racist propaganda, SJW warrior bullshit. Not a bad splash page. Not horrible. I don't get the duster, but that's okay. What is he, Gambit? Or did he steal it from Gambit? Where is Gambit anyway, by the way? Who the fuck knows? I gotta say, between the three women... Prestige now. That's Rachel Gray. She's Prestige. And you got Kitty Pryde. And then you got Storm. Their characters were weird. Wolverine, Logan was pretty good, except he was a little talkative. I don't quite understand. Oh, there was... Was it here? No. So anyways, blah, blah, blah. I'm not going to go through this whole thing because I really don't give a fuck. Where was it? No, it was at the beginning. Where the hell was it? No, where the hell was that moment? There was this section I want to... It was, anyway, you can look at the comic. You can look at some of the art. Whatever. I don't know where the fuck it is, but basically, Kitty Pryde says to whoever the bad guy is... I thought he was supposed to be dead. And Colossus is like, I used to be dead too. And then Nightcrawler's like, yeah, me too. And Logan's like, I hear there's a version of me that is still dead. Which was kind of funny. It was kind of a funny little nod to the fact that we're starting over at number one. And then they had to kill Colossus for shock value because they don't know how to write. They had to kill off Nightcrawler because they don't know how to write engaging stories that keep people coming back. And they had to kill off Wolverine. And this is Old Man Logan from an alternate universe. Okay. Okay. And then we go into the SJW word bullshit. All these people are racist. And Kitty Pryde, well, you could call me a person, you call me a human being, or you're just a mutie, and blah, 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 blah. Who gives a fuck? Oh, yeah. Then we get into racist propaganda, which is this. A quote from the Quran that basically suggests that, you know, the infidels, the Jews and the Christians, you should not engage them as friends because they're not your friends, basically. Basically, they're a bunch of assholes. And then, oh yeah, I forgot about this here. Actually, you got two things going here. You got the Jew restore. Look at that. And of course, that's Kitty Pryde. She's a Jew. Jew restore. Then you got the 212 date, which, and then you come over here. Now they're playing baseball. Okay, this is a tradition. They always get together, play baseball, so it's kind of nice, you know. That's probably about the only highlight of the story. And of course, Logan's over here, very talkative, you know. And it's not bad. The dialogue is okay. It's, again, a bit much, but whatever. And then we're going to do, apparently we're going to do a whole nother mini-series coming. A whole big event coming. They just got off a fucking event. They have to constantly do these events to try to sell because... Like, this right here was a complete throwaway fucking story. This does not make me want to come back, like I said, to issue 2. The only reason I'm coming back to issue 2 is because I've been collecting these for 25 fucking years. That's it. Then you have this moment with Kitty Pryde and Colossus, and I can't be with you. I can't be with you because you want to die for the cause. You do want to live for me, kind of a thing, and blah blah blah. Well, you could be friends, but you want to help. Fuck that bullshit. Bullshit. Put them two together. Shut the fuck up. Oh, and I'm gonna spoil it. Dun dun dun. Who's the bad guy team? Who? The Brotherhood of Evil Mutants, which is the go-to fucking faction that they always have to face every single time. Very innovative. Woo! Very innovative. Again. And now, when I say shitty writers, I'm not necessarily saying that this particular writer, specifically, or that it was necessarily a badly written, but just the overall story. It's just, okay, no, it was kind of cool. You got this collapsing building. Let me go back. There's this collapsing building. Kitty Pryde has to phase the one into the other while Nightcrawler teleports everybody out. Okay, not making me come back for issue two, but it's all right, fine. Oh, there was this other section here too that was some suggest was questionable. So you got Nightcrawler, he's at bat. You got Logan and Kitty over there, and all of a sudden, boom! Smacks Kitty right in the face. Well, obviously there's distance there, but it just happens to be like right. And some are suggesting, because I don't know if that was specific or just, you know, happened to be what it was. But again, she's like the Jew, and it kind of looks like it's smacking her in the face, even though obviously it's, you know, foreground and background. But somebody suggested that. I don't know if it's true, but he did put in some. I mean, he clearly put in propaganda on these couple pages. And some people are like, well, it's just Easter eggs. It's just Easter. Yeah, it's fucking racist Easter egg shit. You know. Which is ironic considering you got a bunch of people who are, you know, bigoted assholes, and then you got this stuff here saying that Christians and Jews are, you know, garbage. Which is kind of interesting in and of itself when you think about it. So, whatever. But yeah, this moment here where they're playing baseball, that's kind of the only highlight of the whole story as far as I'm concerned. The three female characters just felt weird. You know, like, oh, they all have to be run by women now because, you know, and Marvel's like, oh, people don't like women. No, it's not people don't like women. It's just, listen, here's a newsflash, Marvel. If I've subscribed to Wolverine for 25 fucking plus years, guess who I want to read about? Wolver-fucking-reen, not X-23.
Well, you just don't like women. You're a bigot.
No. No, I pay for Wolverine, I want Wolverine. I don't pay for Wolverine and get Spider-Man. Okay? Hell, that would even be an improvement. You know? It's like, I mean, seriously, you gotta understand. Some people have been collecting these for like, you know, since the 60s, and even, who knows, even further back. I don't know how far back this shit goes, but it goes back further than I care to acknowledge. So some people are now collecting it with their grandkids. Okay, and they want to show, oh, here's Tony Stark, and, you know, I've been collecting Iron Man for 40 years or whatever, 60 years, whatever the fuck it is. And,
well, we're going to do SJW Warrior stuff, and we're going to take Tony Stark, we're going to get rid of him, we're going to replace him with a young black female.
Oh, okay, sure. Yeah, because that's what I've grown up with. Now, I'll be honest with you, I don't, whatever the character's name is, she actually looks cool. The artwork they did for that particular character looks really cool. And I'd actually be mildly interested in that. Let's say it was Tony Stark's protege or something. See,
well, that means she'd have to come under his authority, under the authority of the man,
whatever. But it would make more sense in the story. So you have your basic Iron Man. And then you have a spin-off series. Now, here's the newsflash, Marvel. You hook me with Iron Man. I am already subscribed to that. You add in this new character with some interesting stuff that makes me want to engage in that. Now I'm buying two of your comic books. Instead, what do? You replace the character that we've all grown up with and love with a character we know nothing about and don't give a damn. Which we could give a damn, but we don't, because you didn't do anything to engage it.
You're just like, well, we're just going to do this now because, you know, we got to cater to the lowest common denominator and blah, blah, blah.
Okay, fine. Well, guess what? I didn't subscribe to that. All the people who subscribed to Iron Man didn't subscribe to this particular new character. So instead of adding the character into the little world bubble that is, let's say, Iron Man, I'm using that as an example. Same thing with Thor. Like, I subscribe to Thor. I want to see Thor. I don't want to see Jane Foster. Now, if you're going to do, like, a storyline that's going to run its course and then go kind of, you know, go back, that's one thing. But the sister's like, well, no, Thor has always been a woman, and, yeah. No, Thor has not always been a woman. Fuck you. Okay, that pisses me off. That just irritates the bejesus out of me. Now, make no mistake, I like X-23. But not as a replacement for Wolverine that I've been collecting for 25 fucking years. Okay? Kiss my dick. Old Man Logan, I like him. He ain't a replacement. I want the original fucking Wolverine. Why? Because it's what I pay. I am the bigot who pays your bills, Marvel. Fuck you. I pay your bills. Give me Wolverine. Now, you can have Old Man Logan. Guess what? Bring back regular Wolverine. I will subscribe. Keep Old Man Logan. I will subscribe. That's two comics I will buy. And if you engage X-23 into those two, maybe even do miniseries between the three comics, I would be willing to buy three of your comic books a month. Now keep in mind, that one was $4.99. They're five fucking dollars a piece. Now these were number one, so they thought they could get an extra dollar off. But okay, so they're what? They're $3.99 typically. You're talking $4 a pop. Do you understand? No, let me run down this. I don't have much time left on this camera. I want to buy Batman, Detective Comics, Superman, Action Comics. I'd like to get Justice League. I'd like to get Wonder Woman. I'd like to get Flash. And that's just from DC. And then you got that Super Sons where you got Damian, which is Batman's son, and you got Clark's son, Superman's son, which is actually kind of funny because you got them as like being dads and you got the kids, and it sounds stupid, but it actually kind of works and I kind of like it. I'd like to get into that because it's just kind of fun to see them kind of in a different role, although they're still doing their thing, but it's like, oh, it's like the last one you had, I didn't read it, but I saw. Basically, you had them sitting around, and they were playing a game. It was like Bruce and Clark were just sitting around, fucking around with the kids. It was just interesting. Okay, now that would make me want to come back to see part two, see number two. These did not. Now again, I did like the Juggernaut. I thought Juggernaut was kind of cool in this. Black Tom was interesting. But then this one goes into the Brotherhood of Evil Mutants. Ooh, haven't seen them in a while. No, woo, haven't seen those guys in a while. But, I mean, seriously, I pay for a certain thing. I want to see a certain thing. I don't want to see a new thing that I've never heard of before and want nothing to do with because you feel you've got to cater to a bunch of people who clearly are not buying your comic book. Because if all this SJW warrior bullshit was so successful, you wouldn't have to constantly do number ones every 15 minutes. You wouldn't have to constantly do stupid shit every 15 minutes. If this story made me want to come back to number two, guess what? I would. This story made me want to come back. I don't care about number two to see the fucking Brotherhood of Evil Mutants again. I don't give a fuck. Again, the only reason I'm coming back to these two is because I've got a subscription and it's coming in the mail. I don't have a choice. I could stop it and be like, brr. But I've been collecting for 25 plus fuck years and I really want to not, you know, just on the off chance. It's almost like WWE. No matter how shitty it gets, I still watch on the hopes that, you know, they put on a good show for once. Okay? And newsflash, they don't. Anyway, that's the fucking review. There's nothing to come back to. There's literally nothing for me to give a fuck about on either of these titles. They're throwaway titles. They do nothing. They don't engage anything. Now, they are good jumping on points. Like, I haven't even read the, whatever. But they're good jumping on points. That's about all these are. That's it. That's all they are. Good jumping on points. Anyway, that's it. Preview.